In our previous video, we were able to show how the derived quantities relate with the fundamental quantities of mass, length, and time. And we were able to derive how area, volume, velocity, acceleration, and force, how they relate to the physical quantities. In our conclusion, we said that we use dimensions of a physical quantity also to check for the consistency of equations, and we also use it to derive equations. In this video, we shall concern ourselves with how we use the dimensions of a physical quantity to check for the consistency of equations. This is Kisembo Academy, and thanks for tuning in. Now, right in front of us, we have an equation. S is equal to ut plus a half at squared. Most of you know it as the equation of motion. Now, we all know that S is equal to ut plus a half at squared is a correct equation. But we want to use dimensions of a physical quantity to check whether it is consistent. Now, when we are checking for the consistency of equations, we balance their units. It means that we are going to look at the left-hand side of the equation, and we see how the left-hand side is related to the three fundamental quantities. Then we also are going to look at the right-hand side of the equation, and we see how that right-hand hand of the equation is related to the physical quantities, the basic ones. Then if the two coincide, if the two are the same, then we shall conclude and say that the equation is dimensionally consistent. So let's look at this example. We have on our left hand side, we have S, which is distance. So that's why we said on the left hand side, S is going to be equal to L. It's the length. S is distance. So the distance, as far as the three basic quantities are concerned, distance is L. Then we shall look at our right hand side. The right hand side is this other part. Our duty is to find the dimensions on the right hand side to see if they are going to coincide with L. So our right hand side, we have ut plus a half at squared. So we find the dimensions of u times the dimensions of t plus a half times the dimensions of acceleration times the dimension of time squared. And then from here we shall end up with u. We know that u is velocity. So velocity, the dimensions of velocity are lt to the power negative 1, which is that. So we look for the dimensions of displacement, and what are the dimensions of time? So now displacement is actually L, divide that by the time. This is a basic quantity, which is t. So it means that the dimensions of velocity are lt to the power negative 1 times time, which is capital T, plus a half. The dimensions for acceleration is lt to the power negative 2. Acceleration is velocity over time, by definition. By definition, we know that acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. So now, what are the dimensions of velocity? The dimensions of velocity are lt to the power negative 1. We got those ones before. So for velocity, it is lt to the power negative 1. Divide that by the dimensions of time, which is t. So our answer here is going to become lt to the power negative 2. Multiply that by time squared, which is t squared. And of course, lt to the power negative 1 times t, this t and that t cancel, because this is to the power negative 1, this is to the power 1. So they cancel and you remain with L. And then that is going to be plus lt to the power negative 2 times t squared. This t squared and t to the power negative 2 will cancel out, and you remain with a half L. L plus a half L is going to give us 3 over 2 times L. 3 over 2 times L, this 3 over 2 is a constant. And as far as dimensions of a physical quantity are concerned, the constants are dimensionless. So because constants are dimensionless, it means that as far as the right hand is concerned, you remain with L. And so you realize that L and L, they are coinciding. The left hand side is L, the right hand side is also L. So you conclude by saying that since So we're going to our next example. we have V is equal to U cubed plus 80. Now V is equal to U cubed plus 80. Look at, we have the left hand side and the right hand side. So the left hand side is V. V is velocity. And the dimensions of velocity are lg to the power negative 1. We derived those in our previous video. Then we have those on the right hand side, which is this, which is U cubed plus 80. So now we work towards finding the dimensions on the right hand side. The dimensions of the right hand side, we have U cubed, the dimensions of U cubed plus the dimensions of acceleration plus the times the directions of time, t. The dimensions of velocity is going to be lg to the power negative 1, that's for velocity, but since it's to the power 3, so this thing is to the power 3, plus the dimensions of acceleration, which is lt to the power negative 2, this is acceleration, times the dimensions of time, which is capital T. There. Then we go ahead and simplify this. So this is the same as l to the power 3 times negative 3 times 3 is t to the power negative 3. That is plus lt to the power negative 1, because t to the power negative 2 times t to the power 1. Of course, this t will cancel with one of those t's. You remain with lt to the power negative 1. And when we add, when you can't simplify this further. When you, in our next step, we shall still have that. So you realize that as far as our right hand side is concerned, we are having just this. And on our left hand side, we are having lt to the power negative 1. Now, since the units of our right hand side are not coinciding with those on our left hand side, it means that this equation is not dimensionally consistent. So in our conclusion, we shall say, we'll do one more example. We have v squared is equal to 8u squared plus 4as. We are checking for the dimensional consistency of this equation. So checking for the dimensional consistency of this equation, we have the left hand side, which is v squared. So the dimensions of v squared are definitely lt to the power negative 1. That this is for velocity. Lt to the power negative 1 squared. So meaning that it's going to be l squared times t to the power negative 2. That is on the left hand side. So what about this on the right hand side? So let's look for the right hand side. On our right hand side, we have 8 u squared. We need the dimensions of that, plus 4 times the dimensions of acceleration times the dimensions of s, the distance. So now we'll go ahead and say that this is going to be 8 times, now u is velocity. Velocity is l t to the power negative 1. This is squared. Plus 4 times the dimensions of acceleration, which is l t to the power negative 2 times s. S is distance. So distance is l, length. So this is going to become l to the power 2 times t to the power negative 2 plus, that is going to be, this is 8. This is 4 times l is l squared. So it's l squared times t to the power negative 2. So you have here 8 l squared t to the power negative 2 and that. So this plus that gives us 12. 12 l squared t to the power negative 2. But as far as dimensions of physical quantities is concerned, we know that constants are dimensionless. So this is the same as l squared t to the power negative 2. So since the right hand side, which is l squared t to the power negative 2, is the same as l squared t to the power negative 2, which is the left hand side, it means that this equation is dimensionally consistent. Now, we all know that as far as the equations of motion are concerned, the third equation of motion is v squared is equal to u squared plus 2as. But now, this is a wrong equation. As we all see, v squared is equal to 8u squared plus 4as. This is a wrong equation from our theory. But then when we try to analyze it using the dimensions of a physical quantity, we find that the equation is dimensionally consistent. So in other words, it's dimensionally consistent, but it is having wrong values of 8, and for those are the wrong constants. Now, why is this so? Why is this thing consistent, yet it's having wrong values? Now, this is consistent, yet it's having wrong values because 8 and 4 are dimensionless. Therefore, this brings us to this conclusion, that when we are doing dimension analysis, we can use it to eliminate wrong equations, but we cannot use it to prove the correctness of an equation. And why is this so? Because you cannot use it to prove whether the correctness of factors or constants such as a half, 8, 4, pi, etc. are correct. You can't use it. So that's the conclusion here. We can use dimensions of a physical quantity to eliminate wrong equations, but then we cannot use it to prove the correctness of an equation. Please take note of that. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Otherwise, for more of these videos, I encourage you to subscribe and share this video. It's been Arnold Rangakuramia for Kisembo Academy.